I don't know if this is working. Frosty's here. Frosty, how you doing, buddy?
I don't know if this is working.
Hang on, I need to turn the pop comms here. How's it going? So, basically, I've been buying a heap of stray bullets. I've been buying stray bullets since day one, since I started buying comics. And I'm one book away from completing the original series. So, works for me, sorry bro, I have no clue what you might be talking about. Well, to be honest, Frosty, you probably will, like, you can't hear me, and anyone else is not going to have a clue what I'm talking about either. But I'm just going to start showing some Stray Bullets books. So, this is not the one to show first, because it's number two. It's okay, boy. Finn's here, looking after us, so... Stray Bullets number one. This is pretty much, like, my favourite series. Let's see if I can get into this one. What's Stray Bullets about? So it's like I don't want to say it's a crime book, but I guess it kind of is. It's like a lot of people likened it to Frank Miller's Sin City to when it first came out. But it's like it's a long form story for sure. If you're interested in it, check out the Stray Bullets Uber Alice, which is the first 41 issues of the series, and it's based around probably about 20 different characters, and they all interact with each other, but not necessarily at the same time, if you see what I mean. So this first book is, I think it's dated, I'm gonna have to take it back out again, I think it's dated 97. Like, if you're reading Stray Bullets, you've got to keep an eye out on the dates. Yeah, look at that. Right at the start there. Summer 1997? 1997. So the first issue is 97, and then it goes back to 1978, just when Star Wars is coming out, actually. And David says Guinness time. Guinness time's been and gone, I'm afraid, son. Let's go. Let's just show some of these covers, because they're iconic. It's always about two-thirds is Stray Bullets, and then he does a painted cover for the bottom. So the first series has 41 issues. It's a bottle of Maduri and a bottle of Jaeger, maybe? Is it Jaeger? Yeah, of course it is. The Great Legends here. How's it going, buddy? I hope this stream is better than the last one. Like, is the quality all okay? Can people just tell me if the quality is okay? Because I'm kind of watching myself and there's a bit of lag here. Number five. This is the introduction of Orson. That's him there. Cheers, Davis. Much better. Number six, the introduction of Amy Racecar. These are all getting stacked up on Finn. I don't know how happy he is about it. That's Virginia Applejack. We'll just show Finn here again. Books stacked on him. so that's Finn. So this is number 8. This is the first part of the second arc called Other People, maybe? There he is. Number 9. And some of these that I've got are not in the best condition. They're actually quite tough to find. They're not expensive when they do show up, but they are really difficult to find. Like this, issue number 11. That took me ages to find. So it's El Capitan. It's a self-published book, kind of similar to Cerebus. Sorry, I'm trying to read this and speak at the same time. So he won the Eisner 1996 for best writer and artist for issue number 11. Number 12. Number 13. Number 14, and this is like the end of the second arc, so this is like a double-sized issue. These are all black and white, by the way. And then you get the color special, Amy Race car. Hey Tat, how's it going, buddy? Stray Bullets number 15. Number 16. Frog Queen's here, how's it going? If anybody's not checked out the Frog Queen yet, go and check out our channel. Number 17. The Frog Queen's got her shit together in a way that I never will. So, congratulations. Number 18. That's Amy Race car there. Number 19. This has always reminded me of Shaky Kane. It's obviously not, it's Lapham, but number 20. Number 21, and I got this today. And it's not in very nice condition. You can see the corner there, but it's literally the first copy of 21 I've ever even seen on eBay. Your videos are always good, like your hair. Thanks, Tat. I know how good my hair is, so that says a lot about my video quality. Number 22. Number 23, this is Spanish Scott. Shaky just wrote you, Frog Queen. What was he saying? Did he say that Kyle Rowe is one of the best collectors going? I bet he did. Number 24. Some koi, I think, probably. Tat's vids are as good as his beard. Amy Race car again, number 26. Number 27, a new Bulletproof Coffin one shot. Very excited about that. I actually felt that the second volume of Bulletproof Coffin was kind of disappointing. It wasn't disappointing, that's maybe a bit harsh, but it wasn't what I expected after the first volume. But Frog Queen, go search Endless Coffin into Google and it gives you the issue 5 of volume 2. Just the panels just randomly cycling over and over again. So check out Endless Coffin. Everybody, check out Endless Coffin. Number 28. Davis, I didn't know you had any jokes, man. Stray Bullets 29. I love the kind of the bold colours on the top. Bulletproof Coffin one shot though, very excited. Number 30. This is when it starts getting really dark. Actually, no, that's the end of it just being really dark. Number 31. That always reminds me of the Alexis on Fire album, the first one. Anyway, Alexis on Fire. Hey, Mr. Riggs here. Number 32. That's like that classic Akira panel with Tetsuo and the tablet on his tongue. Number 33. Number 34. That's a cool cover. Number 35, I got this one today. This one was proving difficult. Number 36. Good bit of glare on there. These books must be weighing down on Finn quite a bit now. Number 37. Number 38. That's quite a creepy cover. Number 39. Like a sunburst. Stray Bullets. Missing number 40. So anybody who has a number 40, give me a shout. And then number 41, and as you can see, number 41 was the first book to be released by Image. And that's... Sorry, Finn. That's volume 1. So that's the Uber Alice, if you're to buy Stray Bullets Uber Alice. And I'll just pick up the current series. Oh. Okay, so that took him from about 95 until about 2000 and I want to say 16, but I think it was maybe 15. It might have even been 14. Let me just find out here. 2014, so 1995 to 2014 to do that first 40 issues. And then in 2014, issue 41 came out, and at the same time, issue number 1 of his new series came out, Stray Bullets, The Killers. Got a signed one in like this really weird bag and board that doesn't have a top. So, I don't really... I've never seen anything like this before. But one of them... people are speaking. 41 is really nice. Yeah, it is. It's a great end to what we've been hanging on for so long. So I got a signed one and I got a one to read. Glad you're here with us. Glad to make it to work. Yeah, Rig's at work. Yeah, if you buy the Uber Alice, you get issue 1 up to 41. And I think this series, Killers, is also out in a trade, so you can buy this as a trade. There's Killers number 2. Killers number 3. Number 4. Yeah, if you're not subbed to Frog Queen, go check her out. And I think everybody else is subbed to each other, but you know what I mean. Killers number 5. Killers number 6. I think with Stray Bullets, Lapham's really not scared to touch on any subject, and he does it all very well. Number 7. This is Ginny. This is young Ginny. She's still one of the main characters. And number 8. And this is the last issue of Killers. So the second trade from Image. Well, the first trade from Image is this. The first 8 issues of New Stray Bullets. Which would bring Bullets... I think maybe this... Book number 1, Sunshine and Roses, would bring Stray Bullets up to issue 50. Oh, Finn's on the move. Are you going? Are you going? Because I need to rest these books here. Right, you're staying. Yeah, there you go. The backside, Stray Bullets number 50. Davis is chucking subs out left, right, and centre. Sunshine and Roses, number 2. And this symbol here is kind of like the symbol for Sunshine and Roses. It kind of appears quite a lot. You can see it in the background of this one, number 3. I think I'm about to sneeze. So stay tuned for a sneeze. It's coming up. Stray Bullets number 4. Jid's here. Jidlid is here, everybody. How you doing, brother? Everybody go check out Jidlid. Number 5. Number 6, that's Monster. Monster's a great character. Number 7. So Sunshine and Roses is the current series. Number 8. This is Kretschmeyer. He's a new character. Number 9. And the coffee stain is there. It's supposed to be there. Number 10, that's a great cover. Davis, you're doing some laundry, buddy. Should you not be filming a video right now? Number 11. Shaky's got a new series out this summer. What's it called? Issue 12. If you're speaking to Shaky Kane, tell him that he has to draw a picture of me. Why not? It's worth a shot, is it not? Stray Bullets 13. Sunshine and Roses. Issue 14. So this is Joey from the very first issue of Stray Bullets. And a new records. Yeah, I think so. I think I do have some new records. I'm going to be going and having a look again tomorrow, so. The Beef. The Beef, is that what it's called? That's fantastic. Yeah, Jid, I'll be showing some new records tomorrow, hopefully, but I'm still waiting on my last Laura Marling to complete the set. This is number 15. Did you lead Last Driver? Put it back on the phone. No, I didn't. I didn't know. I've been keeping an eye on David Hine. So the last book I read by David Hine was... what was it called? The Second Sight. It was on Aftershock. That was a great book. Six issues, I think it was. Number 16. That's a great cover. I think I've missed the Broken Hand cover. I think I showed that already. AG's here. How you doing, AG? Number 17. Happy St. Patrick's Day, AG. Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody. Oh no, here it is. This is my favourite Stray Bullets cover. Number 18. Look at that. It's beautiful. It's just the best use of this format. Number 19. Number 20. And issue number 21, and it's the 25th anniversary of Image, apparently, this month. So, that's us caught up. You're saying you need to get some of those books, Tat? You need to get all of those books, Tat. So, get yourself to St. Vinny's. I'm just going to go flip the record. I'll be 2 seconds. So, the only kind of new record I've got to show you is, it's not even new, it's an old one. This is You Look A Lot Like Me by Mal Blum. This is the only album she's done that's been released onto vinyl. The one before this, called Tempest in a Teacup, was put onto CD, and that's the first like physical release that she's had. She's on digital. Yeah, she's got a heap of albums on iTunes. She's on like Instagram and all that shit, whatever you call it. Digital media. It's not called digital media. What's it called? Physical. No, what's it called? Like the internet. She's on the internet. Anyway. You Look A Lot Like Me, Mal Blum. This album's great, and the one before it called Tempest in a Teacup, which I think is a play on words from Storm in a Teacup. Yeah, just really cool. She reminds me of like Sonic Youth and like Jeffrey Lewis, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's what she reminds me of. What are we saying? Yeah, Dave, Tat, get to St. Vinny's. Davis is after you to get down there. AG Surfer, guys and gals. Tat's gonna start drinking. It's St. Paddy's Day, obviously. And he's gonna start drawing, so yeah, cool. But yeah, the purpose of this video was to get everybody to read El Capitan books, to read Stray Bullets. The Uber Alice collects, like I've been saying, collects the first 41 issues. So you don't have to be missing 40, like me. And then you're into Killers, and then the current series, which I don't think's been collected yet, Sunshine and Roses. And Sunshine and Roses is canonically, if that's a word, before issue 8. So issue 8 happens and you meet a whole new set of characters and they're in a situation, and Sunshine and Roses tells you how they get there. So yeah, so seriously, check it out. I'm pretty sure, I don't think it's Comicology, I think it's Amazon has the first 4 issues of Stray Bullets for free. So get on there and get them picked up. Oh, Frog Queen, you've got the flu. You need some hot toddies. You need whiskey, basically. You need whiskey. That's the only way to sort that out. AG, you got some comics? Tat, I don't know what that means, but I'm chuffed about it. Yeah, well, last night's not helping you. You need to drink more now. Anyway, I think I'm going to call it a day here. Well, I mean, bourbon's okay, but if you it needs to be scotch. That's why it's not working, you see. You need to drink whiskey. You don't want to drink bourbon. Bourbon doesn't do it. Hot toddies. You see, scotch doesn't count on the liver. It just goes right through, so. Tat's got a drunk finger. Incidentally, that was my college nickname. But yeah, I'm gonna Goldschläger or Amaretto. You don't want either of those. If you've got Goldschläger, you have to pan your poop and make your money back. Anyway, right. Before I just fall asleep on here, I'm gonna love and leave you. So yeah, it was great hanging out with you guys, and yeah, I guess we'll see you for the next one. Everybody, thanks for joining in, and yeah, peace.